So if you want to move all your PC games to a brand new hard drive, but you are dreading having to spend hours downloading your games all over again, well, I'm here to tell you that you don't have to. Because in this series of videos, I'm going to go through the step-by-step guide that you need to follow so that you can get all your games onto your new hard drive without having to download them all again. So a few minutes of your time spent here is going to save you hours afterwards. Now, each video in the series is going to be focusing on a different game store, and this week it's the turn of EA Games. Plus, I'm going to show you how to set up a new hard drive so that it's ready for you to install those games to. Welcome to my tech gear, let's get into it. So before you can start downloading and saving anything to a new hard drive, the first thing that you need to do is set it up. Now, for ease of use, I would recommend an external hard drive for use, as you only need to plug it into a USB port instead of opening up your PC case. However, whether you use an external or an internal drive, the steps for formatting and setting it up are the same. First things first, let's open up the disk management tool. Now, in order to do that, press the Windows key to bring up the Windows home menu, type in disk, and then there is a create and format hard disk partition option. So just click on that. When you open up that disk management tool, you are going to see your default drive in this list. Now, for most people, it's going to be D or an E. For me, it's the OneTouch drive that I've just attached to my PC, so it's E for me. Now, you just need to format your hard drive. So in the disk management tool, click on your hard drive, right-click, and then select Format. By default, you're pretty much going to leave it as NTFS. You can change if you want to, but for most people, NTFS. And then just click on OK, and it will do a quick format of that drive. I'm not going to do that because I've already done it, but that's how you set up a new drive, because it's now all ready, once that format's finished, for you to install new games to. Now, in order to switch EA over to use your new hard drive, we need to do three things. We need to change the default installation folder in the EA app to your new drive. We need to copy all the games from your current drive to the new one. And then finally, we need to tell the EA app to use the new drive for all those games that you just moved. So to change the default installation folder to the new drive, open up the EA app and click in the top left-hand corner and click on Settings. Now, under the Download tab here, you'll see where the default install location is. Now, I've actually already moved it to the new folder, but for you, you will probably see it as C Program Files, EA Games, or something like that. So we are going to change this, but remember this folder location before you change it, as you will need it later, as you're going to need to copy the games from that folder to your new drive. So click on Edit and then select whatever folder you want for your new drive. Again, I like to have a folder for every app store, so I've got an eOneTouch Games EA folder. So from now on, all future games are going to be installed to that directory. Now we need to copy the games you already have installed over to that new drive. So simply open up two Explorer windows. So again, Windows and the E key for quickly opening up two windows. Go to your original folder where those games were in the first place. Now for me, that's D Games, EA Games. And then we're going to go to the new folder in the new drive, and that's E Games, EA. So the EA folder is empty over there. And then simply just drag your game folders over to the new drive, and it's going to copy all those games over onto your new drive. Now, the big advantage of copying rather than cut and pasting is it means that if something goes wrong in that file transfer, well, you haven't lost the original folder, so you can then go and try it again. Once that folder is copied across, we now need to get the EA app to pick up the new folder location. Now, the EA app is a bit of a pain in the backside in regards to this. What we need to do, because the EA app still thinks it's in that old location, we need to change the directory inside the registry of the machine. Now, this isn't as scary as it sounds. So first up, we want to kill the EA app, so we're just going to close that. And it will say it's running in the background. We need to kill those background services as well. So you want to open up the task manager. There's several ways of doing that. I'd like to just press the Windows key and the X key, and then select Task Manager from the pop-up. Now, in this list of processes that are here, you will find EA. So you want to kill the app, right-click and select End Task. And then the background service is probably still running. There we go, EA background service. So you want to right-click on that and do End Task as well. Now, what we need to do, because the EA app is currently still pointing at the old folder, we need to go into the registry and change it to the new location. Hit the Windows key and type in reg edit, and that will start your Windows registry. Now, go to your local machine and software. Now, under here, there will either be an EA Games folder, or sometimes there is a folder for the developer that made the game. So in the case of Apex, for instance, Respawn Entertainment make Apex. So the registry key that we need is under there rather than EA Games. It's not always obvious. There's not one rule. So you do have to do a little bit of looking around in here. So for me, I know it's Respawn and Apex is under there. If you had something like Battlefield installed, there would be an EA Games folder and there would be Battlefield under there. So under Apex, you can see the install directory. And it's currently pointing at D, which is the old folder. So we're going to open this up, double click, and it opens it up here. Now, I want to change this to my new folder, which is E Games EA Apex. So if I just double click on Apex, I've now got the folder that I want to change it to. So if I copy that, so that's Control C, and then go over to the registry, highlight all of that, select delete, copy paste, Control V, and that's my E Games EA Apex, and click on OK. If I now restart the EA app again, right, so now if I click into my library, you can see Apex is there. It says that it's playable. And if you click on the top right buttons there, those little dots, click on View Properties, you'll see it's under E Games EA Apex. So it's picked up that registry key change and it is now pointing at the new folder. So it is a little bit convoluted and it's a little bit more long-winded than some of the other game stores for moving games around, but at least you can do it. I just don't know why EA don't make it easier so that it's just, why can't you just do it inside the app? Anyway, those are the steps that you need to follow. You do have to make sure that you kill that background service before you change the registry key. Otherwise, your registry key changes aren't going to be picked up by this app. And once you've confirmed that everything is working, go back to your original directory and go and delete the original folder because you're not going to need that anymore. And that's EA, all done. If you want to find out how to move games in more game stores or find out which hard drive is best for gaming for you, then be sure to check out the links up here. I will put some links actually to some hard drive options in the description down below for you. Thanks for watching. If you have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and share it. Consider subscribing if you're not. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.